Through Gates Unseen responds to Robert Andrews' incredible work, Tracing Inscription, which I saw a couple of years ago in Melbourne. It's an incredible work that uses many different panels of charcoal, of branches, of stones and leaves, all burnt, smearing, and they're all suspended upon strings across the room, controlled by a plotting machine. And that plotting machine slowly moves and threads each of the strings, and then each of the organic matter, the branches, the ochre, the stones, slowly move and they smear against the back wall, slowly decaying, falling upon the ground, and the work slowly evolves over the many, many weeks that it's on display. I take the idea of the plotting machine that the strings are then suspended from, that move all the organic matter. And I take that idea as a kind of puppet master and built, along with a colleague of mine, Colin Frank, a percussion instrument, a staff, in which a whole bunch of custom instruments and objects are suspended from. So this staff becomes the catalyst, the kind of puppet master to a lot of the material that you hear in the orchestral work. So it instigates a lot of the changes, a lot of the shifts in activity, in mood. The piece has a sort of dirty, grimy, kind of very tactile kind of nature. There's a lot of low rumbling, kind of meandering, low bassoons, low double basses. And the percussion, particularly this staff, you know, punctuate that space, break it up, and then a whole bunch of solos emerge. I think of the solos as these very kind of ornamental and meandering lines, maybe like the remnants of the kind of crumbling material. So there's this real dialogue between these kind of grimy, kind of low, kind of maybe like the smearing, the charcoal, and then these more kind of organic and fluid lines that maybe think about what these materials were originally, maybe their original state.